Hey, this is Maggio Lopez at the Trash Media Channel, and today, it's time to get fit, maggots! Hey losers, it's me. I just came back from doing that stupid meme that you just saw. So, fitness. The absolutely most vain and controversial thing in most people's life. Your fitness might be something you're doing great at, and for some others you're doing terribly. But the important thing is that we have to deal with our fitness at some point in our life. Now you might be a bit confused why some big dude who's always struggled with their weight is talking to you about fitness. Well, it's because I think, like me, a lot of people have thought of their fitness as a visual things like, oh, I need to have that six-pack body, or I need to have that juicy, thick cake. But in recent times, I've realized it's more of a thing about my health and not really a visual thing. And because of that concern, I've decided to take it a bit more seriously recently. So while I am not exactly the example of peak fitness, I would like to share with you what I have learned in about 2 months. I'm gonna split this little fitness journey in about 3 parts: mindset, workouts, and diet. I'd like to make it clear this video is simply to help others with their own fitness and try to help people improve themselves. I genuinely believe anyone can get fit, even if they have their own gravitational pull and they're the size of a small moon, or they're anorexic and they're in between somebody's moods. Let's get into mindset. In my opinion, probably the most difficult part about getting fit is about having the right mindset. For a very long time, I didn't bother with my fitness because I never really had the right mindset for it. I was always like,
oh, people should respect me for the person that I am and not the person that I look like.
And for a lot of people, that is the same case. But I'm gonna have to ask you to get your head out of your rectum and listen to me. Your fitness isn't a visual thing. It is a health thing. If you walk around being the size of a small moon, it takes guts. I don't know how you have more than one, but you definitely have them. So realize that this isn't a visual thing, this isn't about other people's standards. People should respect you for the person that you are, but also know that respect is something you earn. It isn't something you deserve. If you focus on your health, on your appearance, if you groom, if you're constantly trying to improve yourself, whether it be in physically or mentally, or in your career, people are gonna respect you. And in the end, this is what this video is for. I want people to respect you and so that you can learn to respect yourself. Because that is where it starts, in here, in your mind. You have to learn to respect yourself before anyone else can respect you. That's why I say mindset is where you have to start and why it's probably the most difficult thing about fitness. If you feel like roadkill in a dumpster fire, chances are your fitness is gonna be that of a skunk's rotten liver. In order to have the right mindset, you first have to have the proper motivation you need to establish healthy habits, which will turn to the discipline that you need to improve your fitness. Another big part about mindset is your mental health. If you feel depressed for any reason,
then you need to book a therapy session, talk about your depression.
Go see a therapist. Or if you know that you have a problem and you want to fix it, this is when you want to start focusing on your fitness, because now you have a reason to improve yourself. Now that we have a right mindset of self-improvement, let's get into exercise. I'm not going to lie to you, exercising sucks. My intestines through my throat. But if you want to be healthy, it's something you need to do. You don't need to stay at the gym for hours on end or have super intense workouts that leave you sore every single time you do it. If you want to start working out, start by establishing healthy habits. Like I said, don't nosedive into exercise and start doing these super intense workouts for 4 hours every single day. It takes around 60 days or 2 months for your body to register something as a routine. Start by doing 30 or 60 minutes of maybe flexibility, strength, or mobility training. Once you establish the habit to exercise, it's all gonna go uphill from here. Next thing you wanna do is do your research. Are you gonna be doing bodyweight workouts? Are you gonna be using machines and cables? Whatever it is you're doing, learn form, learn breathing technique. These are all very important things to get the most out of your exercise. Also learn how you wanna split your workouts. Do you wanna do upper body days, lower body days? Do you want to do active rests on Saturday and Sunday? Do you want to have actual rest days? Establish a routine. That being said, don't only just study the technical things about your workout. Study your body type. I'm a big dude. I weigh a lot. Because of that, body weight workouts work extremely well for me. I've been doing this for about 2 months now. I have established the habit of exercising for about 30 to 60 minutes every single day. I'm getting into calisthenics because it's very intense and it helps all of my body grow. So learn your body type and what works best for you. Now you also have to realize you can't out-exercise bad habits. Let's get into diet now. Diet, like exercise, is very difficult, and that's why you must establish healthy habits and do your research. Learn your body type. What's gonna help you lose weight? What's gonna help you gain muscle mass? What's gonna let you get more flexible? What's gonna work for you? For me, restricting the amount of calories I eat every single day, exercising and pushing myself every single day, is what allows me to lose fat and gain muscle mass. Now, if you're thinking about specifics in diet or don't even know where to start, just remember this. Fat is a necessity and sugar is not. The most misunderstood part about dieting is what your body actually needs to develop. Proteins, complex carbs, vitamins, minerals, and natural fats are all things your body needs to develop. If you want to get into eating healthier, salads 3 times a day, not only is it bad for you, you just sound like such a basic piece of trash. Diversity is the key to your diet. Not only should you eat a little bit of everything, also take cheat days. Why do I say this? Why would I say take a cheat day? Isn't that just gonna ruin my gains? Yes, but from your diet is gonna be incredibly bad for you, because once you remove it for like maybe 2 weeks and your brain's completely forgotten what that's like, once you like suddenly just like, oh, you know what? You're gonna fall into a sugar addiction. That's why you also include like a little bit of sugar. Like maybe if you drink some juice, go ahead, a protein bar with like a bit of sugar or something in there. But make sure to satisfy your cravings. Look for alternatives to some of your favorite foods. Just make sure your diet doesn't make you feel like roadkill. If you're into keto, go ahead. That's incredibly good for burning fat. If you're vegan, leave. There's the door. I don't want you here. Leave. I'm just kidding. I love vegans. I just hate vegan cyclists. Anyway, in conclusion, get your head out of your rectum, start exercising, start dieting, start taking care of yourself, become a better human. Now get out of my face! You guys, do you hear that? I think it's time to choose comment of the week. Congratulations to Angry Kato, you win comment of the week. You're like a more meme-y Philip DeFranco. I completely agree with you, my dude. Anyway, I hope you have enjoyed the video. Let me do the cringy YouTuber stuff. Hit the bell or go to hell. Assert dominance over the like button. Subscribe and you'll survive.